Thousands of healthcare workers still waiting to receive their COVID health emergency allowance. At the Philippine General Hospital, the unpaid allowance for frontliners go back as far as July 2021. They call on the government to speed up the process of distribution.
Sa ating naririnig yung pakulangan po ng budget, no? Napakahigpit pagdating sa appropriation dito sa ating COVID benefits. At laging dinadahilan ng DOH na wala pa daw release, di umano yung DBM. Kaya nakakalungkot. Pangalawa din, may mga burokrasya din, no? May mga punto na masyadong maraming requisitos na hinihingi sa mga ospital. Ang hiling talaga natin, merong nakatutok na personnel dito sa level ng DOH, sa level ng mga hospital para hindi naaantala ng inaabot ng magtatapos na yung taon at hindi pa rin ito nakukuha.
The Health Department says it has already requested additional funds for the health emergency allowance of health workers.
Just recently, nag-request po tayo ng 27 billion from DBM. We released the letter last November 8 para po makover na natin yung remaining months of the year na hindi pa po nakukover for our health emergency allowance. So antayin lamang po natin yung sagot ng DBM and of course yung issuance para maibigay din po natin sa ating mga healthcare workers yung kanilang benefits sana bago magpasko maibigay natin para masaya ang Pasko ng ating mga healthcare workers.
A health expert says COVID-19 appears to be becoming an endemic disease. But for the health department, the road to endemicity still remains uncertain. Rafael Bosano tells us why.
A low and acceptable number of infections, admissions, and deaths is what the Philippine Health Department continues to look out for to say that COVID-19 has indeed become endemic in the country. Nearly 3 years since the virus first spread, a doctor says the stage of endemicity may just be around the corner.
Mukhang nagiging endemic na siya in the sense na magsi-circulate na yan parang sipon, hindi na siya talaga mawawala ng todo.
Health Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Vergere agrees with this, but she says it would be prudent for the public to maintain caution in light of findings that newer sub-variants of Omicron are more immune-evasive.
Mababa ang booster ng population ngayon, kaya nakikita natin na maari pang tumaas uli kung sakali ang mga sakit dito sa ating bansa. Yun pong mga sub-variants na pumasok dito sa ating bansa evades immunity. We can say that yes, endemicity will come, soon. Pero sa ngayon, it's quite uncertain.
As of November 14th, almost 74 million Filipinos are now considered fully vaccinated. But only 20.8 million have received a first booster, something which according to the DOH has to drastically be improved. Based on the DOH data in the last couple of days, an uptick in case trends was observed in all island groups. But Vergere says it has become more acceptable to the public given the availability of tools to avoid infection as well as severe disease or death. Because of this, the DOH is set to recommend decoupling restriction for every alert level in the currently implemented alert level system for COVID.
We'd like to decouple these restrictions from this alert level system kung saan ang alert level system gagamitin na lang ito ng ating bansa, parang pag-asa storm signals na lang siya. Nasasabihin na sa'yo, signal number 4 tayo ngayon. Alam na ng bawat pamilya at komunidad kung ano ang dapat nilang gawin. Hindi na kailangan na nakatali pa yung restrictions dun sa alert level system.
Vaccines, face masks, antivirals, and hospital readiness have all shown just how far the country has gone in terms of facing the pandemic. Now that COVID's endemicity is becoming more and more clear, experts say that the public should not back down, but instead continue working hard to hasten the country's recovery from the pandemic. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.